Sorry.
Possession here.
offensive rebound.
And their offense looking like a well-oiled machine. First quarter ball, almost 2.5 minutes in. Sharing the ball and creating good shots. And Smitty, even as his game has evolved, Keldon Johnson remains a smart player.
You know, Smitty has so much energy.
He has become more than a downhill scorer. He can hit the jumper off the catch or triple clear. Keep defenders honest. I appreciate the versatility of Mitchell's game. He can get you a little of everything on the floor, not just a lot of points. He's living there tonight, a tough guy to guard without fouling. And the bonus, he's going to knock him down.
Cell, and again, it's San Antonio converting. You can't help but look toward their defense. And they're totally lost. Pass to LeVert. Beyond the arc. That one falls. Nice setup by Mitchell. Mitchell has got 3 assists now on this one.
That's just Mitchell making the right play, finding the open man.
Cell's shot is good. And early on, they've been on a tear. Just getting whatever they want offensively.
They established the pace. They made shots. This is why they're way out in front.
Porter shot is off. Tremendous defensive effort. Saving a bucket right there.
You know what? This is why you never give up on a play. You don't know what's going to happen.
Now here's Mitchell. Consistent production from him. Averaging around 27.5 points a game.
He can get that shot anytime he wants. Because of his ability to blow by you, Donovan gets you on your heels, and he stops and pops.
Boy, oh boy, both teams lighting it up to start this game.
And you wonder how long they can keep it going. At some point, you expect the defense will adjust.
He's been off this whole period, unable to sustain any kind of consistency. They're getting torched on the perimeter. 4 of the last 5 buckets have been threes. Missed by Mitchell.
He's kind of lost his way this period, having a hard time getting anything to go down.
Connex from downtown. Their ability to space the floor has been the story of this game.
If you love analytics, this is what this is all about. They favor the three ball. You can pile up points in a hurry.
And so the San Antonio Spurs, liking their chances, ending the quarter with a 15-point lead. And it's their three-point accuracy that has helped them build such a healthy lead. All right, we'll get back to the action after this break. Great to have you with us. Second quarter of basketball. This game has not exactly been neck and neck, but plenty of time left in this one. And a look now at how the offensive approach has been going here so far for San Antonio.
They're unselfish. They're passing the ball well, setting up teammates, playing team basketball, and their focus.
And also, I like how they've let it fly from the three-point line, shooting with confidence so far in this one. On the court for San Antonio here in the second. They've got Trey Jones, Kevin Cassell out there with Ben Yellen. Then there's Zach Collins, and it's Wesley in at the two-guard spot. Oh, nice ball movement by LeVert. A welcome sign for this team. Allen's gone 4-4 for the field. Perfect so far.
Out of
bounds. We'll go to the Cavaliers. Here's what the Cleveland Cavaliers have lined up on their schedule. On Thursday,
Thursday, they'll take on Ben Simmons and the Brooklyn Nets. And on Monday, they'll be matched up against DeMar DeRozan and the Chicago Bulls.
Looking at this stretch, they should have little issues beating most of their opponents. They just need to keep the intensity up and avoid playing down to their competition.
With the NBA season out of its early stages now, Greg, there have been more than a few surprises.
Oh, I love surprises. And every season, there are a few guys who take a major leap forward. Something just clicks for them or the skills all just come together. But regardless, it's always a fun surprise for fans and broadcasters too.
Mitchell, the pass to Allen. Here we go. AT&T 5G Slam Cam, bringing you the sauce. Here's the cell. And he wills that one in, sinking it right through the back of the iron. The cell's got 12 points.
And just executing at a high level. I mean, taking what the defense allows and putting in the work.
The reason why they stayed aggressive and they have not let up this entire night. And at this point, I wouldn't expect them to.
Wesley, pass to Jones. And again, it's the Spurs from deep.
As the deep shots continue to fall, you can sense the frustration growing among these defenders.
Pass to Okoro from downtown. And that one's good. That makes it 2-for-3.
Anything you can do, I can do better. That one felt a little personal right there.
Sometimes it's a matter of pride.
About Trey Jones. He runs the offense with efficiency.
Yes, B.A., the reason why, he has a high basketball IQ and a calmness, and he never makes mistakes. The speed and agility of Trey Jones is flat out impressive, and it needs to be, because that's how he gets the better of larger opponents.
Wade, he's checked in for Cleveland. Struce comes in for LeVert. And San Antonio also making a switch. McDermott's checked in for Wesley. Pass to Okoro. And there's a whistle that goes on. Doug McDermott. That's his first foul of the game.
First team foul.
Quarter two in about 2 minutes in. Here's Allen. And it's Allen who slams it home.
This is why you must box out Allen, a strong player who can hurt you on the offensive glass.
From deep, Wembanyama. It's rebounded by Cleveland. And going against San Antonio, their first meeting of the year.
And they swept the team last season, got the upper hand, and sustained the momentum.
But hey, it's a different season, and anything can happen.
San Antonio again missing. Cleveland has gone 1-2 from deep in the second quarter. There's Mitchell on the assist by Okoro's got three assists now in this one.
One sign of a great playmaker, hitting his man in stride.
Here's Vassell. It's good. Only a few seconds into the shot clock. Vassell's got 14.
Playing at his tempo, his pace, he's been dialed in all night.
To the paint. Here's Struce. And he goes up strong with a one-handed jam. Right there was a statement finish. Here's Mitchell. Grown man points at Donovan Mitchell.
We've seen that more than once today. An effortless basket inside.
Pass to Wembanyama. And here's Vassell. Here's Struce. And again, it's San Antonio converting.
You can tell he's feeling it. Hasn't missed a single shot all quarter.
All right, let's get a report from Allie.
Hey, Brian, Donovan Mitchell is a man of the people. He said, quote, just being in the community, whether it's going to high school games or barbecues, you never know what that one moment will do for a child. I'm forever grateful that I'm able to do that and get that reaction, and I will continue to do that throughout my life. Guys,
yeah, terrific stuff there, Allie. Thanks for that.
Riding the hot hand, and why not? If something's working, keep going to it.
From deep, Mitchell. Oh, it's blocked by Wembanyama. And the ball goes out of bounds. And the Spurs with the changes. Johnson comes in for Collins. And Devontae Graham is subbed in for Vassell. Cleveland calls timeout.
They defeated Washington in their last game.
And in that game, they owned the glass. Most of the second chance opportunities went to them.
They were able to convert a lot of those offensive rebounds. That's the key. Generate points off those extra possessions.
1 minute left in the first half of basketball. The three from Okoro knocks it down from distance. Give it eight.
Well, Allen is usually the last stop the ball makes, but he selflessly gives it up to a wide open guy.
Pass to Graham. Fires the three. Can't get it to drop. Cleveland has gone 5 of 12 from 3-point range tonight. Struce's shot is off. And so it's Jones who brings up the ball for the San Antonio Spurs. At one point, they led by 16. Here's Mitchell. Mitchell showing some muscle.
Mitchell!
The way Donovan caught the contact on that shot should really build his confidence.
Just 2 seconds between the shot clock and the game clock. Johnson with a bucket.
He just brings a great feel for the game at the offensive end.
Cleveland has gone 2-5 from distance here in the second quarter. The three from Mitchell. It's alive. Oh, he hangs in there and cashes in on the second chance points.
And for Allen, it's about getting to his spots. When he's doing this, he's capable of catching fire.
They get it back. Wimbanyama laid it in with a nice touch off the window. Wimbanyama's got 7 points in the game.
At the end of the day, when the ball goes up, there's no substitute for effort.
And Mitchell puts up a deep three. Oh, he got it up in time, but it wouldn't fall for him. So we conclude the first half. It's the Spurs. They lead by 12. Well, now a minute to check in with Allie LaForce. She's courtside. Hey, Allie.
I'm here with Coach Greg Popovich. And, Coach, you look at the offensive execution for this team. What are you seeing?
I think they've done a pretty good job in moving the basketball, keeping up the pace, because we've been playing in mud a little bit lately, but the pace has been pretty good.
Hopefully that pace continues in the second half. Thanks, Coach.
All right, Allie, thanks for that. We will see everyone right back after this break, ready for the second half.
And now, the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hey, welcome back to the NBA on 2K Sports. This is Ernie Johnson. Kenny the Jet Smith is right here. Say hey to the folks, Kenny.
Hey, folks.
Say hey to the folks, Shaq.
Hey, folks.
Hey, let's get this party started. San Antonio came out looking very confident. At one point, their devastating offensive assault pushed their lead out to 15 points. And they were rolling in that first quarter, up by 15 at the end of it. Moving on to the second quarter, their lead was challenged, but never seriously, as they took a 12-point edge into the half. Shaq, what are your thoughts on how San Antonio played?
Well, they've shown a lot of discipline defensively. It's not about getting quick shots, it's about getting a good shot. If you want to know how that approach is working, just check out their field goal.
And, Kenny, what do you see for Cleveland?
Well, they have to improve their defense. Guys were getting burned on the threat line. They wouldn't put a hand up, like my man used to say, hand down, man down. Oh, you got to get some help. That pretty much covers everything. Shaq, you think they played their best?
No way, no way.
That about wraps it up.
Time now for the second half of the game. We go to Kevin Harlan for the call.
Fans, please give a big round of applause for your Cavalier Youth Dance Team.
Gap on the scoreboard. The second half begins with very different goals for these teams. One side trying to mount a comeback, one side trying to protect their lead. You look at Devin Vassell, he's been playing really well.
Through the first two quarters and change, his perimeter shooting continues to be spot on.
What can you say? Shooting is a premium in this league, and you can see why.
After a very lopsided first half, we'll see if things play out a little more evenly in the second. Mitchell and Struce to the backcourt. Jared Allen out there with Dean Wade. And it's Okoro in on the three. That's J.B. Bickerstaff's five as we get going in the second half.
Oh, the length of Allen is exceptional. Helping him reach past the defense and jamming it home.
And he sinks that one, hitting the back of the rim on the way in. Vassell's got 21 points in the game. The Cavaliers shooting a solid 53% from the floor. Okoro, no good. Well, the Spurs shooting 76%. You don't see this often. And he's
takes that one up and powers it through.
And that's why you don't give up on the glass.
And his efforts, well rewarded right there.
Working hard, beating everyone to the ball. He does this night in and night out.
Pass to Wade. That one's good. Mitchell making the play. Mitchell's got 7 assists in the game. We always see trends come and go in the NBA, Greg. It seems like in the current era, the pick and roll is the go-to offensive set.
Oh, no question, BA. To be competitive these days, you have to be able to run the pick and roll very, very well. And that's why...
What you love about Donovan Mitchell, not only does he explode into his moves, he finishes with authority.
On the AT&T 5G Slam Cam, good looks by our terrific camera crew. Pass to Johnson. Fires from deep. And again, it's San Antonio with a three. Hard to win games when you allow clean looks from the perimeter. Here's Wade. And there's the foul. It's on Keldon Johnson. That's his first foul for the Cavaliers. Thompson, he's checked in for Allen. And it's Porter Jr. in for
Thompson. Porter.
Here's Wade. Right now averaging 5.5 a game. Uses the glass like a layup. Wade's got 4 points now in the quarter.
And they keep on figuring out ways to force the rock inside.
On the wing, Vassell fires the three. Oh, he is cooking right now. 10 for 11 from the field.
They are unconscious from outside. And so far, the defense has had no answer.
You know what? They talked about this at halftime. And they're doing a better job of creating space. That's good planning, and that's good execution. And that's a great look.
Here's Johnson, and again, it's San Antonio converting.
Just one of those nights for Keldon Johnson, making the most of his opportunity.
Just over 2.5 minutes going by in the second half.
You like that he's still attacking, but the results tonight just haven't been there.
And let's send it over to Allie LaForce.
Well, there will always be players looking to change teams, but Commissioner Silver said, quote, when a player asks to be moved, it has a ripple effect. Lots of other players are impacted by that as well. It's one of those issues that we intend to discuss and see if there are remedies for this. Brian, interesting to see what comes of those talks.
Yeah, that is going to be interesting. All right, Allie, good stuff.
They are passing the ball around tremendously right now.
The Cavaliers have gotten 5 of 10 shots to go. Mitchell, the pass to Strus. To the middle. Here's Wade. Banked it in off the glass. Wade's got 6 points.
Great timing. That could be the difference between an assist and a turnover.
With Vassell out there, there's a lot he brings to the table, Steve.
Yeah, he can make a difference at both ends of the floor, and I know they like that about him. If he has an off-night shoot the ball, he still has value with his defense. Tenacious swat by Keldon Johnson. He went, got that one.
Wembanyama, no good. And it's Porter with the ball for the Cleveland Cavaliers. Trailing by 19. Next matchup, they'll be home against the Nets. Wade, that's good. And so it's San Antonio with it. Their biggest lead of the game was 21. Vassell outside, puts up a deep three. An absolute bomb from 3-point range. Vassell's got 27 points. The Cavaliers have gotten 7 of 14 attempts to fall in the half. Tries a 10-footer. And that one's long. San Antonio's gotten 4 threes to fall out of 5 attempts here in the third. Here's Johnson. Count that one. He's 8 for 10 from the field now.
Great pass from Devin. He's all about doing what's best for the team.
9 seconds separating the shot clock and game clock. Porter with it. Now guarded by Wembanyama. From deep, Mitchell. Rebounded by Branham.
And they're plus 5 on the boards after that rebound.
The 3 from Wembanyama. Cavaliers with the rebound. Fast break, Cleveland. Here's Mitchell, plenty of space. Fires the jumper from the corner and nails it.
Mitchell!
Mitchell's got 4 points in the quarter.
Love the assertiveness from Donovan Mitchell. It's what makes him such a deadly scorer.
Count it, good.
Unselfish, moving the ball. Love to see this kind of offense.
That shot, no good. Devin Vassell has been on display for San Antonio, doing some damage from deep. He now has 5 3-pointers in the game. We'll be right back after this word. Let's take a look at our assist of the game presented by State Farm.
And I'll tell you what, this was a no-brainer tonight. Take a look at the precision on this feed. Couldn't place it any better.
This is why you preach teamwork. Some of the most spectacular plays are the ones where guys are feeding off one another.
As we head into the fourth, we'll see if there's a comeback in the works or if it's more of the same for the first three quarters. On the court for San Antonio, Jones and Vassell are the one and the two. Johnson is out there with Jetty Osman, and it's Collins in at the center position.
Had that one in his sights, too. His fifth triple of the game, second this half.
Mitchell against Jones. Pass to LeVert. Beyond the arc. LeVert with a rebound. And for the Cavaliers, they're shooting 51%. Good clip from the field.
Oh, a big finish for the one-handed jam. On the fast break, LeVert's energy is everything. He sticks with the play the whole way and sinks it.
Johnson with a bucket.
He hit three triples in the first half. Three more since. That's nothing to shrug at.
Mitchell with the ball. And Johnson picks him up defensively. The shot goes in.
And force feeding the ball inside. I mean, no reason to go away from what's working.
San Antonio's gone 2 of 3 from beyond the arc here in the fourth. Pass to Osman from deep 3-point land.
And again, it's the Spurs from deep. Man, they're having a hard time defending the triple. That's 3 in a row.
Here's Wade. They get it back. Allen.
And again, it's Cleaver converting.
Good is it to get stops if you can't keep them off the boards? San Antonio's gotten 3 threes to fall out of 4 attempts here in the fourth. Collins passes to Osman. Off target from 3-point range. The Cavaliers have gotten 4 or 5 attempts to fall so far in the fourth. Here's LeVert, and he takes the feed in stride and slams it home.
That's the pass you want. Orchestrate the offense, creating the runs.
For San Antonio, they've gone 3 of 5 since this fourth quarter started. Vassell's shot is good.
12 straight points off threes. This defense is not extending very well.
Down low. Here's Allen. And it's Allen. Slams it home.
Allen.
He's doing what he can do to pull them closer. But it's not enough. He needs more help.
Oh, got that one up quick. Vassell's got 6 here in the quarter.
All 5 of the last buckets they've given up have been from downtown.
Jones against Mitchell, and stolen by Jones. Takes a 3,
and again, it's the Spurs from deep.
They're really employing a deep range initiative here in the fourth, and it's working.
Interesting approach coming down the stretch, looking to rack up points in chunks. Yeah.
You could just see how sick they were there.
That's what it takes to pull that off. Here's Jones, and San Antonio again with a bucket.
Split-second decision by Jones. He sees the shot and just goes up.
Mitchell against Jones. Here's Allen. That one falls. Nice setup by Mitchell.
Allen.
Allen's got 10 points in just the second half.
He's been locked in all night, and he's taking good shots.
Offensive rebound. Jones' shot is good.
Trey has a nice jump shot, but he also is adept at figuring out ways to score inside.
Inside. Well, Steve Close's recent CBA increased two-way player slots. Now teams can carry 3 instead of 2.
How do you like it?
I love it. The two-way Cavaliers.
Lots of guys have been discovered that way, given a chance to play in this league.
Thompson, he's checked in for the Cavs. Porter Jr. comes in for Mitchell. Graham for three, and the three-pointer goes. Graham's got his first bucket of the game, and he's on the board for three. And Cleveland's shooting has been excellent so far, around 56%. And what a complete performance from them. A dominant win in every way for the Spurs. Pretty clear who the better team was today. They dominated in just about every phase of this game, Grant.
VA, it's almost hard to think what didn't go well for them. Their plan, their execution, everything was absolutely on point.
And with this win, they tallied up a total of six wins on the year.
And against a non-conference opponent, you really want to win the first one. They'll go into the next one knowing how to beat this team for sure.
Now, Doug McDermott is best known for that. A sharp shooting big from the outside.
And a moment to look at the scoring approach in terms of where the points are coming from for the Spurs.
They've been lights out from three-point land in this one. The defense hasn't been effective at stopping them, so they have just stuck with the game plan.
Yeah. Another thing you notice are all the assists. The ball just has energy, and everyone is getting involved.
VA, he's checked in for the Cavaliers. And San Antonio with a change here, too. Wesley's checked in.
He didn't have his feet planted.
Graham for three. And again, it's the Spurs from deep.
Leaving nothing to chance. This run, shutting the door on him.
Not messing around at all. They were focused, relentless, and they got the job done.
And one positive takeaway, at least they're finally showing signs of life out there.
They put together some great possessions here at the end. It's a shame they could have used this run much earlier.
And Devontae Graham is going to pick up the foul. That's his first foul of the game. We're in the bonus now, and they'll go to the line.
Yeah, and this is not what they need. Now the clock has stopped, and there are two shots at the line.
Porter hits them both. McDermott outside from deep three-point land. No good on the shot. There's a four-second difference from the shot clock and the game clock. And that one is stopped right through.
A real weapon on offense. Once LeVert sees a few go down, you know he's in the zone.
Pass to McDermott from deep three-point range. From beyond the arc and then some.
Yeah, they blocked out the noise, blocked out the distractions, kept on grinding, and this is their reward.
And guess what? It's going to be a fun flight home. Total team effort. Big win on the road.
And so it's San Antonio easily grabbing this one. Boy, this crowd has to be shocked by the way their team was dismantled.
Shocked and surprised. It doesn't matter what the matchup is. You never expect a road team to just waltz in and cruise to the type of victory like we saw tonight.
And that about wraps it up. For Grant Hill, Allie LaForce, and Steve Smith, I'm Brian Anderson. Thanks for joining us tonight. We'll see you next time.